Good morning, grade 7. My name is Mrs. Woodside, and I will be your teacher for this morning's session. Ms. Brown Evans will be answering any questions that you have during the session. Before we start, you need to get a pencil or a pen and at least 3 sheets of paper or fold a sheet. So we'll give you about 1 minute to quickly get those items. These items are necessary to write down information and answer any assignment. Okay, everyone should have their utensils at this time that you need for this lesson. So we are going to begin. So I'm going to share my screen. Today's topic is on solar system. Some of you may have done it already in grade 7, some may have not. However, you are familiar with it from grade 6. I will share my screen and we will begin today's lesson. The solar system. Now, I want you to take 1 sheet of paper, and if you can draw this graphic organizer, or you can list it from 1 to 8, what comes to your mind when you hear the word solar system? I'll give you 1 minute to complete that. Okay, before we go over some of the information on what comes to your mind about solar system, each answer that you get correct, I need you to award yourself 1 point. So in this section, you will have a total of 8. So when we are finished going over the answers, you will put, if you got 8 out of 8, write it on the side of the sheet, on the side of the sheet of the paper. So, some of the items that should have come to your mind is sun, moons, planets, asteroids, meteoroids, comets, Milky Way and asteroid belt, and stars. So if you got all of those items, give yourself a pat on your back and put your total on the side of the paper. Let's go on. Before we start this lesson, at the end of this lesson, you should be able to define the solar system, examine features of each planet that makes up the solar system, differentiate between inner and outer planets, some words that may come to your attention during this lesson should be planets, which is a large body of solid rock, liquid or gas that revolves around the sun. Asteroids is a big space rock. Meteoroids, small space rocks. Comets, large clumps of ice and dust that travels through space that orbits around the sun. What is the solar system? The sun, the 8 planets and their moons, as well as other objects that orbit the sun, is called the solar system. The word solar means sun power. The most important part of the solar system is the sun. As you can see, it's in the center of the solar system. Let's look at the sun and moon. The sun is also called a star, and the moon are satellites that orbit every planet except for Mercury and Venus. Now we're going to take a look at the solar system as a whole. So we have the sun right here that we said is the star. Then we have Mercury, we're going to name it in order from the sun, Venus, Earth, Mars, Jupiter, Saturn, Uranus, and Neptune. Now remember I said 8 planets. Anyone could tell me why I said 8 planets? Yes, Pluto is considered now a dwarf planet. However, it is still a planet. And in most maps or pictures, you will still see Pluto in the solar system, but we all know that it is a dwarf planet. Now, here's a clever way to remember the order of the planets. Mercury, we normally say my for Mercury, very for Venus, Earth is educated, mother for Mars, just for Jupiter, serves for Saturn, us for Uranus, and nachos for Neptune. But you could come up with your own acronym. Now, you know, in Bahamian terms, we don't use nachos, we may use noodles. So you could say, my very educated mother just served us noodles also. Now, let's see if we could remember those order of planets. Now, we said, my very educated mother just served us noodles. Now, on this map that I'm showing you, it is showing Pluto. So the dwarf planet, if you could see at the top, it says, label the planets of the solar system. This includes the dwarf planet. However, I want you to take another sheet of paper and letter it from A to I. Then you're going to put your finger on the screen so that you will not get confused in the order. And you will put A, for example, right here. You will put A on your paper. And you will tell me what A is, which planet is A. Now, then you will put your finger on B. That will be the second planet. You will tell me what B is. Then notice, I jumble up the letters. So you will go to F on your paper, skip the rest of the letters, go straight down to F so you wouldn't get confused, and tell me what F is. So remember the planets in order. I will give you 3 minutes to complete this assignment. Okay, let's go over the answers. So A, before we go over the answers, for every answer you get right, you will give yourself 1 point. So this will be out of 9. So after we have finished going over the answers, this sheet of paper that you're writing on, the tally is out of 9. So let's go over the answers. A, is Mercury. B will be Venus. F will be Earth. G will be Mars. H will be Jupiter. I will be Saturn. D will be Uranus. E will be Neptune. And the last one will be Pluto. So put your total on the side of your paper, tally up your scores. Now we're going to take a look at the planets a little more in depth. So you're going to watch a video at this time on the solar system. During the video, I need you to write down one description that you can remember about each planet based on what the video says. So take a look.
Storybox.
We can see the whole solar system from here.
I think we can hear it from here too.
We are the planets of the solar system, different sizes for everyone. The music never ends, we are such good friends, and we all orbit the sun.
You go. The sun rapping first on this track. From the beginning, I'm the center of the solar system. Planets be spinning around me. So hot, I'm roasting, you see. Now I pass a mic to the planet closest to me.
Mercury, the smallest planet, small as Earth's moon. I get super hot and cold, and it's been very slow.
I'm Venus, I got mountains and volcanoes and spray. I'm the same size as Earth, but in the opposite way.
Yeah, I'm Earth, I'm the home to every boy and girl.
Such a beautiful, beautiful world.
I'm Mars, a red planet. I got deserts and ice, and I've got two moons. That's like one moon twice.
I'm Jupiter, the biggest planet. I'm humongous, gargantuan. I spin the fastest, rap the fastest. Plus, I'm handsome, glam, son.
Oh, please, I'm Saturn. Check out my beautiful rings, made up of billions of rocks, dust, and other things.
I'm Uranus. I say that with pride. Okay, I lied. I'm embarrassed because I'm the only planet lying on its side.
I'm Neptune. I'm cold, dark, windy, and mysterious. I'm very stormy, so bring an umbrella. I'm serious.
We are the planets of the solar system. Different sizes for everyone. The music never ends. We are such good friends, and we all orbit the sun.
Well, we are done exploring the solar system. I am thirsty. Well, let's explore the rest of the Milky Way galaxy.
Okay, I hope you enjoyed that video. Now, if you love rap, you should have been able to interact with that video a whole lot. Now, we're going to look at the differences between the planets first, and then we'll look at each planet individually. So based on the video, you should have noticed that the planets are different in distances from the sun. They are different in size. They have different temperatures, and they do not rotate at the same speed. However, all of them have one similarity. Each planet turns on an axis, which is an imaginary line through the planet's center connecting the poles. Our solar system, we already said it is made up of the sun, eight planets, their moons, asteroids, and comets. So let's look at the inner planet. These are the rocky planets. If an astronaut goes out into space, if they stand on the planet, there should be no problem because it is a solid rock. They are the four closest planets to the sun: Mercury, Venus, Earth, and Mars. Remember, my very educated mother, they're the first ones. Now, Mercury. Mercury is the closest planet to the sun, and it is the smallest planet. It has no moons or rings. Venus is the sister planet to the Earth. It has no moons or rings, but it is covered with volcanoes, mountains, and springs similar to the planet Earth. That's why we call it the sister planet. Earth, like we said, it's the home for every boy and girl. It is the third planet from the sun, the only planet known to have life and liquid water. The atmosphere is composed of nitrogen, 78%, oxygen, 21%, and other gases. You should have learned this in science. Mars. If your favorite color is red, this is your planet. It is the fourth planet from the sun. It appears as bright reddish color in the night. It is called the red planet. It has two moons, Phobos and Deimos. Now we're going to look at the outer planets. The outer planets are the remaining planets away from the sun. Those planets are composed of gases. Imagine if an astronaut tries to stand on those planets. If it is made out of gases, they will sink right through. They are Jupiter, Saturn, Uranus, and Neptune. Let's look at Jupiter, the big daddy planet, we call it. It is the large planet in the solar system, the brightest planet in the sky. It has 60 plus moons, 5 visible from Earth. Then we have Saturn, the 6th planet from the sun. It is the diva planet because of its beautiful set of rings. It has 31 moons, the largest moon, Titan. Uranus, the 7th planet from the sun, 27 known moons. Uranus is the mysterious planet. It is set. Uranus is the special planet. It sits on its side, north and south pole sticks out its side. Now the 8th planet, last but not least, it has 7 known moons, Triton, the largest moon. Now this one is the dark and mysterious planet because it has a great dark spot through, thought to be a hole similar to our ozone layer hole in the Earth. Those persons who do not know what an asteroid is, who can remember it from the vocabulary words? Yes, it is a big, large rock. Comet, this is a picture of how a comet looks. Who can remember what a comet is? Yes, it has clumps of dust. Okay, so we're going to look at the planet inner and outer more closely. So I need you to watch this video, get another sheet of paper, and you will be able to jot down some notes based on what the astrophysicist is going to tell you in this video.
Hi, my name is Aileen Perez. I'm an astrophysicist, and this is the difference between the outer planets and the inner. Hi, my name is Aileen Perez. I'm an astrophysicist, and this is the difference between the outer planets and the inner planets. So let's first talk about who are the inner planets and who are the outer planets. So inner planets is Mercury, Venus, Earth, and Mars. Outer planets is Jupiter, Saturn, Uranus, and Neptune. So let's talk about some of the main differences between them. So first, let's talk about location. Okay, so the inner planets are closer to the sun. So close to sun. The outer planets are far away from the sun. So they're far away. Now let's talk about the actual size. So the terrestrial planets, the inner planets, are very small. They're all rocky bodies, very small. And the outer planets tend to be very large. Just Jupiter is over 300 times the mass of the Earth. So they tend to be a lot bigger. So they are large. In terms of mass, these ones are very non-massive because they're so small, they don't have a lot of mass. And these are very massive. Now let's talk about the composition. The chemical composition of this planet tends to be very rocky. So it's a terrestrial planet, rocks with metals. So it's dense. But these planets are made out of their gas giants. So they have a lot of gas. So they're not very dense. Okay. So now let's look at the structure. So the structure of these planets, they either have zero to a thin sort of atmosphere and a terrestrial body, And if you look at the structure of the gas giants, they have very, very large atmospheres with a theoretical rocky body, a rocky core. That's what I mean by that. And now let's talk about the rotation. So the rotation of these planets is slow. Since it's solid, it takes the whole body to move. So slow rotations. Now the gas giants, because they're gases, they have differential rotations all over their bodies and they can rotate a lot faster along its axis. So fast rotators. Now in terms of orbit around the sun, because these are closer to the sun, they orbit faster. So orbit faster. And because they're so far away from the sun, they have slow orbits. Now let's talk about moons. So generally the inner planets have very few moons, you know, Earth has one and so forth. So few moons. The outer planets have many, many moons. Like Saturn is, I think the count is about 70 moons. So lots of moons. And then the last difference is that the inner planets don't have ring systems, but the outer planets do have rings. So they also have rings. And those are some of the differences between the inner planets and the outer planets. My name is Eileen Perez, and I'm an astrophysicist, and this is the difference between inner planets and outer planets.
Now you're going to take a minute and jot down any other information you can remember from the video. So we're going to look at inner versus outer planets. To your left, we have the inner planets. From left to right, we have Mercury, Venus, Earth, and Mars. Then to your right, we have Jupiter, Saturn, Uranus, and Neptune. This is how the planets look from planet Earth in outer space. So you're going to take a sheet of paper, make a T-chart. On one side, you'll put inner planets. Inner planets are also called terrestrial planets. So you'll put that in brackets so that you can remember that. On the other side, which is your right side, you'll put outer planets. And put Jovian is another name for outer planets. You'll put it on that side. Based on the notes that you took from the video, I need you to put them in the correct column. I'll give you about 3 minutes to complete that. I only need about three differences for each one, but I know you're a smart bunch of guys, so you're going to put at least 5. But if you only could remember 3, that's fine. For those who did not get the notes earlier, if I was going a little too fast, don't worry about it. I will recap so that you could jot down any other information that you did not receive. Remember, I said that you have to name at least 3 differences. But if you want to challenge yourself, you can list 5 or more. Yes, you're writing this on a separate sheet of paper. I will go over the instructions again. You're going to divide your paper into 2 sections using a T-chart. One side will have inner planet and the other side will have outer planets. Based on the video, you need to give me at least 3 differences between the 2 types of planets. Okay, you have 30 seconds more. Okay, let's look at the answers now. Inner versus outer planets. The four planets closest to the sun are the inner planets. The next four planets far away from the sun are the outer planets. That's one difference. Another difference, the inner planets are smaller or small. The outer planets are large. The third difference, remember I said that the inner planets are rocky and they are made out of rocks and metal, very dense. The outer planets are made out of liquid and gases. They are called the gas giants. The fourth difference, they are fast, they have a fast orbital period because they are closest to the sun. The outer planets or the Jovian planets, they are slow orbital periods because they are far away from the sun. However, the inner planets have slow rotation periods because they are made out of rocks and they are very heavy. So it's going to take some time for them to spin. The outer planets have fast rotation because they are made out of gases. So they are fast, they are easier to spin around. The inner planets have few moons. The outer planets have many moons. So I'll give you about 5 minutes for those persons who need to jot down the differences between the inner and outer planets. Okay, so let's review. What you're gonna do, I don't know if you want to write down the questions. I'll let you write down the questions and answer them. It's 1 to 10. It's very short questions. I prefer students to write down the entire question so they can know the answer to the question. So it says fill in the blank, it gives you a statement, and you tell me what planet, object they are talking about. So let's write down 1 to 10. I will switch the screen when everyone says they are finished with this slide. So write down 1 to 10. We're going to fill in the blank. Some persons say they are done with this slide. What we'll do so that we don't have to come back to the slide, I'll give you a minute to answer the questions and then we'll go over the answers for this slide. Then we will return, go to the next slide, write down the questions and answer the questions. Okay, number one, those who are not finished, you can catch up. I'll go slow as possible so that you can write it down as I'm going through the answers. A large rocky object orbiting the sun. If you said asteroid, you are correct. So that's 1 point, it's out of 10. Number two, the closest planet to the sun. Think about that acronym that we said. What is the first one? If you said Mercury, you are correct. Number three, this planet is the largest in the solar system. Remember, we refer to him as the Big Daddy planet, that large planet in the solar system. If you said Jupiter, you are correct. Blank is the name of a star in the solar system. Let me give you a hint. It is the most important object in the solar system. If you got sun, you are correct. Number five. This planet is sometimes referred to as the red planet. Now, those whose favorite color is red, you should remember this planet now. Yes, it is Mars. So those persons who are jotting down, we're going to go to the next slide. And at the end of the presentation, I will go back to these questions for those persons who need to jot down it after the presentation. So let's go to the remaining five questions. So those persons who want to jot it down, I'll give you 3 minutes to answer the questions. Once you're completed answering the questions, just type done or complete in the chat box, the Q&A box. Okay, everyone should be finished. Let's go over the answers. Number six, the name of the satellite in the solar system. Satellites are, let's see, moons is correct. Number seven, blank is the home for every boy and girl. Everyone should get this one right. Bird. This planet lie, L-I-E, it should be on its side. Uranus. Number nine, this planet, or these planets, I should say. So that means we are referring to the inner and outer planets. These planets are called the gas giants. Anyone knows inner or outer? Drum rolls. Outer is correct. Number 10, these planets have no rings. Inner planets. Is correct. So those person who want to jot it down, we'll go back to it. That's the end of my presentation.
Conch, our national dish, has now become extinct throughout the Bahamas.
Good evening, Bahamas. I'm Jiminy DeSwain. This is the Bahamas Tonight, the national report.
Restaurants are closing down and fishermen are going bankrupt. Environmentalists say that this is a catastrophe. Once conch is gone, it's gone.
Diving. Heard them say resources slow. I noticed things was getting slow. And man, I really thought that they was lying. How our delicacy could ever become mystery when all around me is the sea.
My, oh my, my. Should've left them babies in the sand. Why, oh why? Should've give them chance to grow up. Should've give them chance to multiply.
We must think about tomorrow. There's some simple rules to follow. Preservation, moderation. We need some conservation.
Come on, come on. That's what I Welcome, sixth graders. Today, together, we are going to explore the various ways we can protect our marine resources. Throughout the video, you will be able to identify the prohibited methods of fishing and discuss closed fishing periods for some animals. Let's begin by calling the vocabulary words aloud together. Pollex, prohibited, tournament, breathing, and dredged. There are perhaps one or two of those words that you may not know the definition of or be familiar with. Let's read through the definitions. Beginning with polyps. Polyps are small animal whose skeleton makes up part of a coral reef. Prohibited. Prohibited means against the law. Something that is not allowed. Tournament. Tournament is a competition. Breathing refers to reproduction. Dredge, to dig out. Laws for fishermen. Some Bahamian fishermen still use traditional methods that have been handed down for centuries from one generation to the next. These methods are protected by law. The vast areas of banks, reef, and sea that surround the islands of the Bahamas provide our country with a valuable resource. Many types of seafood. Let's view the map of the Bahamas. There are three major fishing grounds in the Bahamas, and every Bahamian fisherman goes to one or all of them. These are highlighted on the map. The Great Bahama Bank, the Little Bahama Bank, and Key South Bank. Yes, the art of fishing is very relaxing and enjoyed by many. However, some fishermen have become greedy and catch fish in ways that destroy the environment. Therefore, the government has placed laws to prevent fishermen from using methods that would harm the environment. The following video gives a brief description of what can possibly happen to poachers who are caught fishing illegally in our waters.
Officers from the Royal Bahamas Defense Force are searching for four Dominicans that were aboard two skiffs that accompanied a Dominican fishing vessel intercepted on Friday on the Great Bahama Bank southwest of Great Exuma. The Defense Force confirmed that 18 Dominicans were discovered on board that vessel. An undetermined quantity of scale fish and crawfish was also found aboard the 100-foot steel-hulled vessel. Now the HMBS Wally Gray will escort the vessel to New Providence, where the vessel crew members and fisheries products will be turned over to officials from the Department of Marine Resources, police, and the Ministry of Finance for further investigations.
Do you remember what the word prohibited means? Yes, something that is against the law or not allowed. Let's read together the prohibited fishing methods in the Bahamas, starting with number one, the use of bleach or other poisonous substances for fishing is prohibited. Number two, it is not permitted to use scuba equipment to catch fish or collect marine resources. And finally, number three, the use of guns or explosives is prohibited. Now that we know prohibited fishing methods, let's discuss fishing regulations in the Bahamas. These regulations protect various different animals, beginning with the lobster. Yes, there is an open and a closed season as to when fishermen can capture the lobster. From April 1st to July 31st, no lobster is to be removed from the sea.
Never found gold in Bahamian waters? That is probably because you're not a fisherman.
Like the snappers and the grouper and the conch, we'll call them silver, and the crawfish will be gold.
And with August 1st right around the corner, seafarers of New Providence are ready to get the 2019 crawfish season off to a start. But first, they say, there's a long checklist of items to complete before they can be ready to go out to sea.
We get make sure we get enough fuel to be on the boat. Make sure we get enough grocery to last for a long time out to sea.
The fishing regulations in regards to conch states that if a conch shell does not have a well-formed lip, it should not be removed from the sea. No turtles may be taken from the 1st of April to July 31st. The hawksbill turtle is an endangered species. This turtle should not be taken from the sea. Did you know that it is forbidden to take turtle eggs? Yes, it's against our fishing regulations. Also, there is a minimum size for landing a turtle, which is 60 centimeters back length for the green turtle and 75 centimeters back length for the loggerhead turtle. There is also a closed season for the capture of the Nassau grouper from the 1st of December to the 28th of February. The capture, the purchase, or selling of bonefish is prohibited. Fishing regulations regarding stone crab states that no crabs are to be removed from the water between the 1st of June and the 15th of October. Also, the claw length of stone crab should be at least 10 centimeters. Sports fishing is enjoyed by locals and tourists. However, the directors of any sport fishing tournament must have a written approval from the Ministry of Agriculture and Fisheries to organize or hold any tournaments. Let's recap today's lesson, students. Beginning with this question, what is an example of a prohibited fishing method? Let's see how well you did. If you said or thought of the use of bleach, poisonous substance, guns, explosives, or scuba equipment are prohibited, then your answers are correct. Question number two. Can you name all six animals mentioned that are protected by fishing regulations? Your answer should include lobster, conch, turtles, the Nassau grouper, bonefish, and stone crab. Question 3. If a member of your family decides to host a fishing tournament, which government ministry do they have to seek permission from? Yes, the Ministry of Agriculture and Fisheries. Well done, students. Remember to review the video as you complete your online activities to help you with answering your questions.